Hello, and welcome to this brief training on using advanced search on JSTOR, a digital library with a wide range of primary and secondary source content. JSTOR continually releases new content and features, so your view may not exactly match the examples in this recording. The advanced search button appears in the search drop-down menu near the top of any page on JSTOR. We are now on the advanced search page. After the first keyword box, you will find field choices. These will appear after each box as you design your search. You can use this field choice drop-down menu to limit how the terms in that particular box are searched. The second keyword box begins with search parameters, often called Boolean operators, named after the 19th century mathematician George Boole. The great thing here is that you don't have to remember all the Boolean operators because they appear in the drop-down menu at the beginning of each keyword box. Your librarian has the expert knowledge to help you construct a search, but generally here is how each operator works. The operator AND will narrow your search results by telling the search engine to return results that have both search terms present. OR will find items that contain either term. NOT excludes some results that have an unwanted word in them. The NOT operator should be used cautiously because it's easy to inadvertently exclude relevant materials that have both your terms in them. NEAR is helpful for proximity of one word to another in a text. It should be noted that on JSTOR, NEAR operators only work when searching for single keyword combinations, not phrases. Here we are back on the advanced search page. Boolean operators are written in capital letters to signal the system that this is an operator. Now, let's run a search using one of these operators so you can see how they work. We'll come back to this page in a minute and refine our results. We are now on the search results page. Let's look at how the results are organized. You will see the numbers of primary and secondary sources that your search yields in the Refine Results sidebar. The total number of images in your search results are listed in that sidebar, along with the totals of other primary sources. You might also find, as with my example, that some images are shown under the Image Results heading, displayed before the rest of your search results. These are the images that best match your search terms. Less relevant matches can be viewed by selecting Images under the Primary Source Content in the Refine Results sidebar, or by clicking the link to view all images after the Image Results. Below the most relevant images, you will find the most relevant text items that appear in your search results. These each include a brief excerpt that shows an example of the search terms in context. Looking at how these terms appear in the excerpts can help you decide how to modify your search. You can modify your search in the box at the beginning of the page, or if you use the Modify Search button, you'll be taken back to the advanced search page, where you can modify your original search. We are now on the advanced search page. We recommend using that Modify Search button when revising your search because your terms and operators are in the boxes as you left them. If I make changes here, I can always come back to this page again using the Modified Search button on the search results page. I invite you to experiment with any of these advanced search options on your own. If you have any questions, use the support button to navigate to that page or contact support@jstor.org. Happy searching!